Mission the Light, April 20th, 2018, John's Torture, Letter 130, Second Part of Revelations of Jesus Christ through Apostle John, The Seal Scrolls Now Are Open, Part 2 of 3. I was hungry, I was thirsty so much, I was so cold. One more night had passed, and the third day of my torture was here. Again, they tie me outside. Now they were six soldiers. They were hitting me without mercy. The lasses made whistle noises. Today they were hitting me everywhere, from my head to my feet. They were laughing as it was a fun game for them. I must pass out because now I was with my guardmen on as I was wearing when I left the cave. I had bare feet. The nails of my feet were filled with dry blood. Hot blood was coming out of my thin body. The superior had told me that this will keep happening to me every single time he hears that I was making my speeches to the crowds. And not only that, the crowds were to face the same as me, the abuse. They threw me outside of the military place. I couldn't move, not one single step I can make. I was in pain and my body was weakened from my hunger and my thirst. It began to darken outside and I was in the same place where the soldiers threw me out earlier that morning. Suddenly, I felt hands to pick me up and put me in the back of a donkey. They were two boys. The two young men explained they had learned about everything about me. They waited patiently to darken outside so they can come and take me. My face must have been swollen, my lips cracked and full of blood and dry. I couldn't see clearly because my eyelids were also swollen. I couldn't speak a word. They took me to their home and they gave me a bath with warm water. They placed me in a bed while they had dressed me with clean garments. The boys put few drops of warm milk in my mouth, and then nothing. I saw myself up in the heaven together with the other disciples who already they been martyred as I knew it. Then I saw the Lord. He was caressing my hair. He was kissing my face. He was blessing me for a long time. I was young. John was a young man again. All of us, we were young, as when the Lord was gathering us with him on earth, each apostle and each disciple. I was smiling, and our Lord was smiling also, and my brothers. Happy songs the angels were singing around us. I heard the Lord saying, "My children, my beloved disciples, you are mine. Well done in your faith and the trust you have for me. Well done for your sacrifices for me. Well done who you believe without a second thought in Father and me and the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit never abandoned you, but simply was birthing in you even more faith and strength. Strength so you can continue with love to share your divine duties. You left yourselves to me with full trust. I myself will place crowns on your heads. My little John, you also withstand as the rest of your brothers the torture. No, John, you will not go through any more torture, and they will not going to take away your life from you. For you, I have other plans. You will bear witness with blazing fire, and you will reach many souls. You will warm many souls with the reminders of my words and my teachings. Don't hold nothing back, my child. Pure John, I am the one who will open the path for you. I will enrich your spirit to eternity, now and later in the last days, and that you must share all with all my children, your brethren. Drink from this crystal cup the cool water. Eat the immortal bread. I will always bless you and lead you. Trust me. now and in the deep future. In the deep future, when I bring all this again in your memory, walk in peace. Alleluia. Amen.